In a couple of minutes, I'll be telling you that I'll leave links in the hoo-ha bar to the various pieces of software and firmware that we use throughout this project. Actually, I won't. What should have been a task less than half an hour in length turned into a two-evening marathon. Yeah. The only thing that I can say is massive thanks to Specs for sticking with this. And I implore you to watch this video through to the end before you even make any decisions on any action you want to take, let alone take any action itself. Oh boy, was this a journey. Oh boy. I think it's recording.
Okay, hello internet.
Hello internet. This is another video with the one and only Specsbean Farmer, the guy who's forgotten more about Android than I'll ever know. And we are here today, we are gathered here today, to marry Sailfish to this phone.
Hello, yeah. Little one X.
I hope we can do something for it, because it's speaking Dutch and I don't speak Dutch.
Ah.
Or the only Dutch I speak is, my Nederlands is niet goed, goed Engels spreken alstublieft.
And that means I don't speak any Dutch. Can you speak English, please?
You got it. Got it in one. Damn, I can't fool you, Specs.
Well, there we are then.
Okay, sound warning before we begin this. If you repeat any of what we're about to do and you brick your mobile phone, the responsibility is on you, not
all
us.
On you. All on you. Not us. We take no responsibility.
Exactly.
It's a grown risk. You will be voiding your warranty by doing this as well. So.
And your sanity, probably.
Yeah, probably sanity too. But,
okay.
Hey, this would be fun.
Oh, fun. So, I'm the nervous one. He's done it only a few hundred times before.
Well, I mean, I've never done this before. This is going to be a new experience. I've never worked on a 1X or any of the OnePlus devices, but I've worked on plenty of other Android devices before, so.
Now you tell me. Now you bloody tell me. Thanks.
But Charles, what you've got to remember is that a lot of these devices use the same technology. So we're using Fastboot and ADB primarily for this, yeah. and TeamWin's recovery program. So, if you've used it on one device, you've used it on a million. There might be some slight idiosyncrasies, but we'll work around them. So let's crack on, shall we?
Okay. The one thing you'll find in the hoo-ha bar is links to anything that goes on. Currently at the bottom left of the screen. Unfortunately, Specs can't see my screen because I'm on Linux beta Skype. But you'll find a link to the guide that we're about to be following. Underneath that is a link to the base Android that we're using. Also a link to the Sailfish that we're using, which is specific to this particular phone. Underneath that, you'll find the links to the repository to add the repository, update and get ADB tools and Fastboot, which we've already done, as you can see in the middle of this.
I'll also send Michelle some Mac and Windows versions of the Android tools repositories. So, like Brew for Mac and Windows, you just need to install the Android SDK for that. So,
cool.
Yeah.
In the middle of the screen, you can find the two zips that we've already downloaded, and this is the installation of the repository and getting the latest Fastboot and ADB. So, we're ready to rock. Over to you.
Brilliant.
Specs.
So you've installed, you've done your sudo apt-get installs for your Android dev tools. So your Android tools, ADB and Fastboot.
Yep.
And they're installed.
Yep.
Okay, so first thing I need you to do then is in the terminal with your phone plugged in and ADB enabled. So have we enabled ADB on your phone yet?
No, how do I do that?
Right, check to see if you've got developer tools enabled first. So,
this is good because it's in Dutch.
On the phone itself is go to your settings. However you get there is up to you. I just drag down from the top and click the settings cog.
That's a good one because this is in like. Can you read Dutch?
Ah, right, okay. So if you go to there should be an icon that looks like a world. That should be language as an input.
A world. Tala en
Yeah.
infuer? Yeah.
Like a it
Needles.
should be in around the account section,
I got
or the
it.
personal section.
I got it. I got it. I got it. English United Kingdom.
There you go. That's what you want.
Oh, hoorah!
Brilliant. So we're back in English now.
We're back in
Fantastic.
English. Sorry, Mark, we don't need you help for this one. You're okay, dude. Sit back, have a relax, and watch us make a mess of it. Okay, I am there. Where do I enable developer?
So if you can't see developer options,
Yep.
if you go into About Phone at the very bottom
Yes.
and see Android build version or build number.
Android version 5.1.1, build number ONE.
Yeah, right. So just tap that build number like a lot until it
I'm
says
now
you
a
are.
developer.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
So that was the build number, which is ONEE, whatever. It was right down the bottom.
It was right down
Okay.
the bottom. We don't really care what it was. We just need to tap that a lot until we unlock developer tools.
Developer options is now there. I can see it. And developer options
Okay,
is now on.
so we need a micro USB cable now.
So I don't need to do anything in here.
Well, you might have to in a minute, but we need to plug your phone into your computer
Okay.
next. So that's
That
what
is
we'll do.
done. Ooh, it's all gone red and funky. It's all gone red and funky. Yeah, it's got little red outline boxes around everything, around all the
Oh,
options.
right, you've accidentally clicked something in the developer
Okay.
options.
Oh, got you. Show layout bounds.
Yeah.
Me and my fat thumbs.
Brilliant.
Okay, that's back to normal. Or
Yeah.
abnormal, or whatever the hell.
So, in the USB settings thing, one of the options should be ADB debugging.
That's on the phone, yeah?
Yeah. On the phone in developer options, just make sure ADB debugging is enabled. And then in your terminal, once that's done, I need you to type ADB devices so we can just check to see that your phone is actually being detected. And from there we can then start sending commands.
USB debugging.
Yep, that's it.
That's it. It was under the debugging options. USB debugging on.
Fantastic. So now from your terminal,
Yep.
I want you to run ADB
Yep.
space devices.
Daemon not running, starting it on 5037. List of devices attached, empty.
Empty. Right. What's your phone saying? Because your phone is probably asking you to authorize ADB debugging at this point now.
Nope. Oh, connected to a media device. Tip for touch for other options.
Yeah.
I have media, camera, or charging.
Now media should be fine. Just double
Empty
check
there.
that it's enabled in the developer options for me.
Okay. Just double checking that this is actually connected to the right computer.
It's another problem you might have. You've got lots of computers that look exactly the same. There are at least
Yes.
two.
Let's just swipe away Wi-Fi network. Forget it. USB debugging connected. Touch to disable debugging. Oh
Nope,
no.
we want to keep it that
Okay.
enabled.
Yeah. That's
So
there.
try ADB devices again.
No. Not showing.
One second, let me just. Oh, I don't have ADB installed on here. One sec, let me just install the Android tools. Updating Homebrew. Ah, the beauty of Mac.
No comment.
So you definitely got it on the right.
OEM unlocking is an option. Allow the bootloader loader to be unlocked.
Yep.
Okay, I'll switch that on. That was off.
We definitely want
Advanced reboot. Oh, ADB
yeah,
over
we want
network.
advanced reboot because we could do this without ADB in that instance actually. So enable advanced reboot.
Yep, that's enabled. There's ADB over network, which is enable TCP/IP debugging over network instances. Wow.
Yeah, you don't need that right now.
That's the only thing which I can immediately show. There is one called verify apps over a USB. That's turned on.
Okay, well,
turn that off.
No, it should be fine. If you've got the advanced reboot options now, if you power down the system or try to power down the system, you should get some more options. One of them should be restarting to bootloader mode. That's what we want.
No, power off, reboot, or screenshot.
Yeah, if you click reboot, what does it do? Does it say, are you sure?
Yes. Reboot, recovery, or bootloader.
Bootloader, please.
Bootloader. Your phone will reboot.
Sweet.
That is now rebooting.
Try fastboot devices when it gets into the bootloader.
It's in fastboot mode, apparently.
Yeah, brilliant. Okay, so see if it can be seen by the computer now. So type fastboot devices.
No permissions, fastboot. Well, hang on. Do I need to do this as root?
Try doing
yes.
it as root.
Bingo.
Yeah, sorry. That's a Mac idiosyncrasy. when it installs via homebrew, it chones it to your user, so you can use it as... Yeah.
Okay, so the my ADB devices command may not have worked because I wasn't in root.
Yeah, maybe. Possibly.
Possibly. Okay. Okay, fastboot devices is not actually coming back with anything at the moment.
Isn't it? You're saying no devices found?
Yeah.
You sure it's plugged into
on.
The right machine?
It's sudo. Okay, I know it. I know what's going on this. Sudo pass wd root. Okay.
Is it coming back with a device now?
Yes. To let you know what I did, because this is a fresh installation that I've made just for this video, just for us to do this, I hadn't enabled a root password, so I just had to enable a root password, and now I'm SU'd into root, so everything I type will now be as root.
Oh, right, okay. So you've just sued into root. That's fine. Yeah.
Yeah. So we now have fastboot devices. I have a number and fastboot.
Brilliant. Right, fantastic. So now you want to type fastboot space OEM dash unlock. Then that should unlock your bootloader.
No.
This will wipe everything from the phone, no?
It doesn't. It's giving me a lot of options.
Oh, right, okay. Let me just check something then. It's, I'm sure it's fastboot.
Install you?
Grep OEM. No, that didn't work. fastboot unlock. No. Fastboot. One second, I'll have to Google it. I'm sure it was just fastboot OEM unlock, but clearly not. Fast. Oh, there we go, right. Fastboot. OEM. Oh, it's just OEM space unlock, sorry.
Okay, no problem. Done. Whoa!
Yep. You should get something on the phone now.
Yeah, it rebooted. It went... Oh my god, what's it doing? Unlock will erase user data. Continue. Yes.
Yep.
Wiping. Please wait. It's so much better when they make it easier like this, as opposed to so much more difficult.
Oh, well, the Samsung devices is the bane of my existence when it comes to this sort of stuff. Well, you know.
We have done some previous Samsungs.
Yeah, we have done some Sammys in the past, haven't we?
It's giving some weird graphical thingy, going through some shapes. Circle, square, an arrow, circle.
Yeah, it's going to do loads of crazy
it's
stuff.
Working.
Huh?
Yeah,
it's doing its thing. So once that's done, we need to flash...
Android is starting. Optimizing app. It's optimizing 122 apps.
That's fine. That's just you can bring Android now.
Okay.
Because you've unlocked the bootloader. So once it's finished doing what it's doing, we'll reboot back into the bootloader.
Okay.
We might have to do that via ADB this time, or you might have to re-enable dev stuff because we've dev tools because we've just formatted the user space.
Okay, I've got a blue welcome screen.
Yeah, you should have to. It's basically just going to re-reg, reset up Android now.
Okay.
So this is like a fresh install
So do I go through this?
of
Or do I tell it to reboot from this point?
if you can get to settings and set up developer tools and then get back to the bootloader now without going through it, do that. If not, then you'll have to go through it so we can get back to the dev tools. The you know not sorry, we can get back to FastBoot, the bootloader.
Okay,
My
I'm
bad.
nexting
Beeps
everything.
kicking
I'm
in.
skipping everything.
Yeah, skip, skip, skip. Next, finished.
Yeah, OnePlus setup. We will now help you to personalize your OnePlus experience.
We don't care.
Next, next. Just there. Input
Mean, it'd
menu.
be great if you were setting this phone up as an Android device, but you're not, so.
Swift key keyboard or Google keyboard? I'll
In
just use the
case.
Google for now.
Yeah.
Okay, now I'm through to a tick. I've got a welcome. I'm back to the what seems to be the usual install.
Android. Launcher.
It's in English this time.
Brilliant.
Developer options have gone, so I'm going back down and tapping on build number until it gives me the developer options. Developer options are there again.
And then just do the advanced power settings again, and we'll go through it that way because it's just easier than messing with ADB.
Okay, USB
But
debugging
before we
is.
do that, before we reboot,
Yeah.
I want you to copy those zips across to your phone now.
Okay, bear with me. So I'm clicking USB debugging on a little
Yep.
further down.
You should have advanced power management or advanced power settings. Power options, maybe? I can't remember what it was called now. Something along those lines, though.
We must be unlocked already because I don't see that thing.
I'm not sure.
I don't see the options that we used before. So it was reboot into bootloader, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, OEM unlocking is on.
Yeah.
Advanced reboot.
There we go, that's what we want.
Okay, that was actually slightly above the debugging options.
Right.
Okay, so that is on. What I'm going to do is see if I can actually see the phone on the USB, and I can. Internal storage?
Yeah, so we're just gonna plump it on there, unless it's got an SD card in there, that would be better. Because
No, it
we're
hasn't.
gonna wipe. All right, and that's fine. It doesn't matter. We can always ADB push these across anyway, so. But we'll just copy the Android base and that the Sailfish image across.
Okay, those two zips are
Both of them are
going
just
over
zip.
intact.
Great, and they just go into the root of the internal storage, yeah?
The root of the internal storage, okay. I've shifted them to downloads, but I'll move them into the root.
Oh, that's fine. Yeah, we should be able in Twerp, you should be able to navigate the file system and
Okay.
select images. So.
Okay, they're there in download.
Okay, cool. So the next thing we're gonna do is reboot into bootloader.
Okay, so I'm pressing the power button. It gives me the options.
And you wanna hit reboot and then bootloader. And that should get you back into FastBoot.
Okay. Reboot. Rebooting. So I pressed the pa held the power button. It gave the usual options. I selected reboot and it gave me the extra menu for bootloader. And then I went, okay, we are in fastboot mode. I'm seeing
Okay,
that
brilliant.
plainly on the screen.
Right, next thing we want to do is flash our new recovery image. So
Okay.
you've got that Twerp recovery image that I sent you.
The two zips.
No, there should be a recovery.image file as well. If you don't have that, I'll send that again. It's in the link. It's the ID 15644.
Oh, 644.
Yeah, if you haven't downloaded that already, download it now. It shouldn't take too long, it's very small.
No problem. So what is this
Redirect
called?
that
The
to your
recovery image.
Yeah, and it's the twerp recovery image. You want to rename that to recovery.img and stick it in your current working directory.
Just recording that.
You don't necessarily have to rename it. It just makes the whole process easier because, like, just copy and paste
Okay, I've got that recovery
a command over to
twerp.img.
it.
And you want me to copy that to the root of my home, yeah?
Wherever your current working directory is, yeah. Like, you could CD to that directory if you liked, but we
You're
just
gonna
need
love
that
this.
file in the current, PWD.
You're gonna love this. As in, you're not gonna love it.
Okay.
I've just in Firefox right-clicked and asked to open the destination, and it's fucked it.
Oh.
It's screwed my entire installation.
Oh, great.
We are currently talking on Skype, but this is bollocks. I'm gonna have to reboot the machine.
Okay, well, call me back when when the technical difficulties are solved. Peace.
This is when I'd love to have one of those. What do you used to see on TV when the channel was closed? The test
Oh yeah,
car.
like the little like boo
Yeah.
with the like girl and the clown
You got it. You
and
got it. Oh,
the
God. Catch you in a second.
Yeah.
Okay, after that brief sojourn, we're back. And what I'm going to do now, I'm in the download section and I'm going to copy this image file to the home folder so it's immediately accessible to the to my command prompt, as you can see. And you say rename it, yes?
Yeah, rename it to recovery.img.
Rec.img, I'm going to recover it
Yeah,
too. Yeah,
that's fine. I mean,
nice and short.
yeah, you're gonna have to type the word recovery anyway, but
Right.
and you could tab complete it, I guess, but
Now you tell me.
well, I don't know. I was trying to make it easy for you, but I don't know.
Since when did I
It's
ever
one
make
after
anything
the
easy for
other. It's all
myself?
good. It's all good. Let's just get to work on there now.
Yes, we have the phone in fast boot mode and we're ready to rock.
Cool. So can Fastboot see it? Run me another Fastboot devices. Just make sure we
Oh,
can see
hang
it.
on.
Oh, make sure your sudo didn't root as well. I mean, I'm
Fastboot
sure you can.
display, wasn't it? No, fastboot devices.
Yeah, you might have to CD back to your home folder as well. I don't know.
Sorted. Now I'm there. Okay.
Okay, so now you want to type fastboot space flash space recovery and then the name of the image.
Yep. That it?
And that's it.
It's going. Finished.
Cool.
Wow, that was
So
quick.
now you want to just say fastboot boot recovery. And your phone should boot into recovery.
Cannot load recovery. Fast boot recovery.
Yeah.
It says no such file or directory.
Oh, right, okay. Just fast boot reboot then.
Okay, the phone's gone blank.
Okay.
This is scary.
Is it rebooted into fast boot mode?
Don't know.
Or is it rebooted in normal Android?
I think it's rebooting into normal Android.
Okay, cool. That's fine. So when we get Android back up, we're going to just use the advanced power menu thing and reboot into re recovery this time instead of bootloader.
Okay. That was quick.
Yeah, it probably will be. It's a fresh install of Android now. And that
Reboot into
phone is
recovery or bootloader?
recovery, sorry,
Recovery.
recovery this time.
Okay. Recovery.
Yeah, and you should see the Team Win recovery.
So what did we just do?
So we just installed a custom recovery image.
Okay.
So think of that like the recovery partition on Windows or Mac or Linux. It's there just to like help you facilitate reinstalling operating systems, creating backups. You can
Okay.
sideload applications this way as well, but.
Right. I've got a menu up. Internal storage. Internal from a install from ADB. Wipe data and cache. Advanced or exit.
So we want to wipe the date on cache list, I think. Let me just double check with the install guide. That's always a good idea. Even if you know what you're doing, always double check, because these devices are expensive. And yeah, like I said before, I've done this millions of times
Yep.
on different devices, but never on this one. So
Double, triple
yeah,
check.
double, triple check. So we want to install the zip via these instructions. So I'm just going to load up them instructions again. And we want to, so we want to install the recovery. Then we want to clear data factory reset. Then we want to clear the cache. And then we want to flash the ROM. So we want to go into, in Team Win, what are your options again, Michelle? Sorry.
Internal storage,
Yeah.
install from ADB, wipe data and cache.
Right, so we want to wipe data and cache.
Okay, so this will this destroy the file system that we just put on
Possibly, but it might not d delete your downloads folder if you
there?
copied them there. Might do.
Factory reset, wipe data, wipe cache.
So we want to wipe data
Wipe
and we want
data.
to wipe cache. We don't want to do a full factory reset. We just
Sure.
want to. Oh, yeah, we do want to clear data and factory reset, sorry.
Okay, so it's wiping the data. Wipe success. Reboot or done?
Done.
Done.
Clear the cache as well.
Wipe cache. Cache will be wiped. Yes.
Okay.
Cache is now wiped.
Cool.
Done. Next.
So next we want to flash the ROM provided in the download section. So we want to flash the CM12.1 ROM. So see if that's in your downloads folder still. So go to internal storage.
Okay, internal storage. I've got what appears to be the bog standard users. So I'm going to go down to the download. In other words, what I'm seeing is the usual home folders that I'd see, which means ringtones, alarms, notifications,
Yeah, your
pictures.
standard sort of Android internal storage layout.
Yeah, so I'm going to my downloads and I can see those two zip files.
Cool. So you want to install the CM12.1 first.
I've got MA12.1. And Sailfish on Onyx.
Right, so you want the MA12.01
Okay.
first.
Install package? Yes.
Yep.
That's updating. So what we're doing now is putting cyanogen on the phone, yeah?
It's
Okay.
just a, and we're using Cyanogen as the base Android or the base like so we're probably just using the kernel and a few of the other programs that come with binary utilities that
Okay.
come with CM, and then we're going to install Sailfish
Installation
over top of
failed.
that. Oh, okay. So try factory reset.
Oops.
That's okay. I mean, it doesn't matter. We'll just factory reset, clear all the caches again, and try again.
Okay, I can't actually get up in the menu structure.
Oh, right, okay, you might have to reboot then.
Okay.
Let's just go back into it.
I can't actually reboot with the power button.
No. What does it say on the screen?
I've got the OnePlus thing. Is it okay to unhook this at the moment?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it should be fine.
What I've got basically is that.
Ah, right, okay, so it looks like you didn't install Team Win properly. I don't know. So let's just reboot the phone. Just hold the power button until it switches off. It should switch off eventually. Might take 5, 10 seconds.
So this is the wrong recovery, yes? Okay, it's gone off.
Okay, reboot it. Switch back on.
Okay,
It
it's
might
coming
just boot
back.
into recovery. Let's
That looks
see.
to me like it's going to go for a full reboot into
That's
Android.
going into a full Android, yeah.
Yeah.
Onyx image.
That's basically what I just did.
Yeah, but we're going to try and flash it this time.
Flash it. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, we're in fast boot mode on
Run.
the phone.
Okay, cool. So now we want to say fast boot. Flash recovery name of image. So twerp 0 twerp 302.
That's fast boot space. Flash flash, space, recovery, space, and the name of the image. Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah.
Finished.
Cool.
And the phone is just sitting.
Can you use the phone? No, it doesn't. It didn't say anything on the phone, like write in.
No. Nothing.
Okay. Okay. Try and fast boot recovery dot like the name of the image again.
Fast boot. What boot?
Boot name of image. Yeah.
Booting. Okay, finished, and the phone is just sat there.
Okay, so from Android, then if you've got to reboot it manually, boot into the recovery this time.
Okay.
I don't get why it's not.
I'm having to hold down the power button in order to get this to foobar itself.
Yeah, switch off and stuff. I wonder where Amy's gone. What's that?
Given the length of this, she's probably pissed off and bugged off somewhere else. Where's something more interesting?
Yeah,
oh well, after all that. Oh, bloody hellfire. One of the things that we've caught up with to date is that we've gone back to my Mint installation rather than a clean Ubuntu installation, and this thing is at least talking correctly with ADB.
Yeah, we've had some problems with Ubuntu today.
Yeah. But a few things still haven't worked. If I say a fastboot reboot bootloader, the phone flashes and it goes back into fastboot mode very quickly.
Cool.
So it's listening to that.
So that's good. So, fastboot boot and then the name of the recovery image.
I have. It just sits there, it does nothing.
Fastboot boot recovery.
Nope.
Nope.
No such file or directory.
Fastboot reboot recovery? I don't know, I don't think that's gonna work either, but
no, I just got all the environment variables. Environment variables? Options.
Yeah, options.
What was the one that worked? Was it the 15644?
Yeah. It was the 644 one. Pretty sure. Luckily, we recorded that, so we'll know.
Yeah. Jeez.
Nah, like clockwork's gone off the fucking face of the earth. It's ridiculous. The fact that it won't even boot anymore as well off the, like, when we're sending it.
Yeah.
That only worked once, which is bizarre. It's bizarre that it worked once, but it won't work again.
Hmm. Okay, what are we left with?
I'm a bit lost, if I'm being honest. I mean, it should just install. Like, it should just be a case of flashing it and then booting it. And then all we've got to do then is flash the ROMs, and then you should have Sailfish. That is what should be happening. I don't know why it's not. The only other thing I can think of is try another machine, but we've done that.
Yeah.
Have a Google.
I'm going to stop recording.
Yeah.
Here's the phone. The good news is, it works. Specs managed to get it on the phone. Ah, long story, where to begin? And it goes even further beyond putting this on the phone in the first place. One of the issues was that whenever you put a new recovery on the phone and then reboot, the phone replaces the recovery with a standard OnePlus recovery. That's one of the key problems that we were hitting. So what we attempted to do was wind Android forward to the latest version. We managed to get a recovery on, but then the recovery was too new for the version of Cyanogen that we were trying to put on. So we had to wind it all the way back to stock. Then we managed to get a recovery on, and then from there we were able to use a recovery that was able to handle the larger file sizes for the Cyanogen image, and once we got that on, it was no brainer to put the Sailfish image on top of that. There were a few extra complexities on top of that, such as we were wiping the Dalvik, the cache, and something else, but the long story short is we had to be brave enough to actually delete Android from the platform as well, so that all we were left was the fast loader and the recovery. And if we mucked those up, then there'd be no chance of going into Android because we'd have deleted Android. So we had to be confident that we could at least get into fast load, and that from there we could actually put a recovery on, which eventually worked. There is a bit of a problem with the community ports, and if I'd known this from the start, then perhaps I would not have done, well, embarked on yet another lunatic project. The community ports cannot have Dalvik for licensing restrictions. Dalvik is the part which is responsible for being able to run the Android applications. So that means no Microsoft Exchange and no Firefox. Yeah, bit of a bummer. But with this port has come a number of extras. There is a tri-state down here, which I can also use. There are a number of ambiences on the phone, and you program the ambiences for the background picture, your colour theme, and your audio. So it's more than just, I've just flipped it down, but there's been no response from the phone because it's switched off. It's dead easy to handle, and it does more than just silence the phone. You can program the ambiences to be whatever you like. So you can actually program the ambiences for different funky sounds and different volume levels and different graphics and different modes for whatever mood you're in, for whatever you happen to be doing. So it's actually quite a bit more flexible. I'm still at the lock screen because there are a number of things that have been done here, one of which is that it's listening to the swipes on the phone. So I don't even have to unlock it to access the torch. Also, if I want to make a call, bink, in this case it knows that I haven't made any previous calls, so I'm accessing the previous call list. I'm just going to lock this again, and how's that? In case you're wondering, this is the generic YouTube music, so I'm not breaking any copyright. It's incredible. There's a number of innovations that are on this particular port that aren't on the standard Yola Sailfish, and I don't recall seeing them on any other mobile phone ever, to be perfectly honest. So you can control these while the phone is locked. You can also start the camera with an O gesture, but there seems to be a bug. It's always front-facing, and if you happen to be in stills mode, the camera just freezes. So I've reported that one. But There's a hell of a lot of innovation going on here. I've also got the controls for the audio that I'm playing, and swipes. No calls. Yes, I know. I'll just close that. It runs on swiping, basically. It's a bit awkward because I'm trying to hold this to the camera as well. And the gesture control is pretty cool. You've got everything in here that you could need. I've just got the conversation. It works on pull-downs, on pulley menus, as they're called, which give you various options. I've already had various alarms wake me up in the morning and do other things. I needed to be up at 5:30 yesterday morning, for example, and everything worked fine. And even the clocks have a distinct way about them, a distinct approach, that when there's my clock and I can just make a new alarm, the clock is that face, so I can immediately tap in 1900, 1925. I can immediately tap in the degree on the clock face itself. You know, no more messing around with things and which days I want it to repeat and save. There's all sorts of innovative stuff going on here. But the net result is, yeah, it's quite stunning the way they're going forward. It's an inventive swiping gesture control. Takes a while to get used to, no doubt about that. I mean, when you think about how long it took us to get used to many of the push interfaces, the button interfaces that we're used to now, once I got used to swipe and particularly the pulley menus, knowing where things were, things got a lot easier. There is a problem in that some of the swipes are different in Sailfish 2 to Sailfish 1. They've changed some of the things. I do seem to have got past a number of issues that I had in the community, and I seem to have started some discussion going. Indeed, I'm a bit disappointed to the degree that it doesn't look like Yola are engaged with the communities. There are ideas and requests that I put forward like 2 or 3 years ago, when I started with Sailfish, quite a number of years ago now. But, you know, Yola do nothing with them. That there's nothing to say, okay, we're listening to this, no, we're not going to implement that. And there's no sort of control over the closure or history of any of the requests from Yola. You know, I repeated a request, and I've sort of had a bit of a battle with someone over, for example, the developer option to disable the audio level warning. It was a suggestion I made years ago, and someone kept trying to close it due to it being a duplicate. And I've had a bit of a running discussion about, yeah, but, you know, what's exactly happening here? You're closing it because it's a duplicate, which was made years ago, but it's still there from years ago. Nobody's picked it up. You know, what's Yola doing here? And my throat's starting to go. So yeah, there are big issues in my mind about Yola. Has it abandoned its own community? What's going on here? Obviously, there are now inputs from Russia, China, and also Sony are involved. If I go onto the Yola website, and unfortunately the Yola website is another one of those sodding things that will not come up if you've got cookies disabled, which is a real... But if you go to yola.com and go into the latest news section, you'll find that from February 27th, Yola adds support for Sailfish OS on Sony's mobile's Xperia devices. Mobile World Congress 2017, Barcelona, February 27. Yola Limited, the developer of open operating system Sailfish OS, today announced support for Sony's Open Devices program to provide a leading hardware platform for Sailfish OS licensing customers and the Sailfish community. So it does look like Sony Mobile are opening up some Xperia devices to be an open devices platform, which hopefully is going to be one way of another way of breaking the stranglehold of iOS and Android and allowing a bit of freedom to the mobile phone community. You know, which I think is what we need. It's hideous that we are tied to two companies which want to slurp all our data, you know, and dictate to us what we're going to get given. And with Sony doing this, you know, Japan getting in on the action, I think over the next few years we will see changes in the mobile industry. The race appears to be on to break the stranglehold of Gapple. Yeah, whatever you want to call it. And I think that Sailfish will be possibly at the spearhead of that. And I think it's got some incredible strengths on it. It's a real shame that the Dalvik can't be ported to the community ports, because some of the innovations that are on this are, yay, give me more, give me more. Yeah, they've actually done a pretty good job of it, but it is a shame that even this, the thread on this, does seem to be slowing down. And I can understand why, especially if licensing of some of the key technologies that are needed to drive the community ports forward are being denied to the community. So, yeah. I'm very grateful. Very, very grateful to Specs for investing the time in sorting this out. I don't think it's been a waste of time. It's been a heck of a learning curve. And I'm still not confident in. We didn't have to root the device. So long as we had a way of getting into fast boot and then a way of loading up a recovery image that would work with the images that we wanted to put on there, it worked. Brilliant. The reception does seem to be better than the original Yola. So now I'm a bit stuck. although I can do without Firefox, it's not ideal because all my stuff is synced between devices. And Exchange means that I can't get up my works calendar, which is a real sod. Or rather, the Exchange connector. Because once the connector is on board, it links the Yola calendar to my works calendar. So I can see the works calendar, the Exchange calendar, in Sailfish, in the Sailfish calendar view, which is a big bonus. yeah, so it looks like I'm stuck with at least two phones for the time being. I can but look forward to Sony's Xperia running Sailfish, and hopefully Yola actually listening to some of what the community is doing. Whoops. Because it really does feel right now like Yola has switched off. Okay, it's now got corporates and even governments to talk with and appease, and that's certainly not going to be easy for it. But if Yola abandons the community in the way that I feel they've abandoned the community from their own forum, this is not going to go very well. It just feels like it's going to end up, you know, we've seen it all before, especially with Google of all companies. You know, do no evil and all that jazz. And then when they became a corporate interest, oh boy, look what happened there. They seized the power, and I'm hoping that remaining open is going to mean that they are going to be accountable and accessible, I hope. But with closed licenses like Dalvik, I mean, I've only heard from one source that Dalvik is not able to be ported over because of licensing restrictions. But if that is the case, and more of the technology that Sailfish runs on goes that way, it's not going to be good. It's not going to be good at all. Certainly, from the mobile phone aspect of these things, it looks like it's going to be a very, very interesting ride for the next few years. And For the purely reception aspect of this, I mean, it also works with the Bluetooth, but even if with the Bluetooth headset enabled, other sounds are not making it through. Like with the Bluetooth headset enabled and Bluetooth other connected devices, it's not playing the media through those devices, which is a bit of a bummer, which does restrict it a bit. But as long as I can make and receive calls and the signal strength is stronger than the Yola, I'm happy. I'm currently holding it in my hand and I'm getting 2G, very low signal. And, yeah. It's going to be one to watch, and I really do think that it's going to be a viable way forward for the people who do want something other than Google and iOS. And I really do think that it's going to cater to the creative people, you know, the people who, the very reason why some of the people have been eschewing Windows for a more supportive, intuitive operating system, like what they receive with iOS, like what iOS has given them to Mac OS, sorry, has given people from Windows. Sailfish is going to be the same escape vector for people who want an escape away from the sort of push aspect of Google and iOS, I believe. And yeah, people are going to find difficulty with the interface as and, you know, as people have moved from Windows to Mac OS, for example, it's a heck of a jump, and this is going to be another one of those jumps. Would I recommend Sailfish to someone yet? No, until the hardware brings up. I mean, the original Yola phone, great, but Sailfish was still catching up. Now Sailfish is more mature, the hardware is not up to spec, and the hardware needs to be up to spec, because things like the camera on the Yola are not there, the reception isn't really there, and a few other odds and sods. The only one thing that I really do regret about the OnePlus X as a phone is the non-replaceable battery. The DAC on here is impressive. It has driven the HD 600s. It's driven the 300 ohm impedance headphones. Ah, that is what called. That's why I asked again that we need to disable the audio level warning, because the high impedance headphones in this, I need to turn the phone volume up, and every time I'm hitting the, you could damage your hearing. Chip, press this to agree. And I keep hitting that, and it's driving me absolutely bonkers. But yes, some things do not work with the port, such as the USB audio doesn't work, the lapel microphone doesn't work, so sadly, it doesn't look like we're going to be able to use that phone to do the driving videos again. I have posted these things in the forum, which isn't the Yola forum, it's the ex-dev forum for this particular port, but things do seem to be slowing down. I really hope they don't. I really hope they take this forward, because even without the Dalvik, some of the stuff in here is just... it's just so cool. It's just so cool for school. They are just doing so well. Incidentally, for the music swipes to work, you have to have the media player running. So it has to be running when before you lock the system. But yeah, then it's always there. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. They really are going somewhere, and top marks to them for this port. It's a sign of things to come. It really is a sign of things to come, and I'm stoked to see this kind of development, this kind of thinking, moving forward. I just, hope that Yola themselves are listening to some of the stuff that's going on. I really do hope they're listening. Bye for now, and thank you for watching. This was as much a painful video to make as it was to watch. Trust me. Bye.